Again, thank you for joining me. I want to talk to the awakened Hebrew Israel. Now that you have been awakened, now that you know that you are the people of the book, the question then is, what next? What should you do? Or what should we do? What does our God require from us? These are the things, the questions that I will address in this this discussion. So you are now awakened. You realize that you are really the people of the book, and that everything that is written in this book is about you. So the question now is, what do we do? How do we please our God? What does he require from us? So let's get into it. What should you do? As one awakened by the help of the Spirit of our God, you should keep in mind that similar thing happened to our ancestors around AD 33, before the judgment of God came upon the nation of Israel. The apostles had to speak and preach to the peoples, helping them to see this is what God is about to do. And the message was so powerful that the people that listened and heard what Peter said asked this question in Acts chapter 2, verse 37 to 39. They asked, what should we do, brothers, what should we do? And Peter responded and told them, repent of your sins and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Yes, the first thing that is required from us as you are now awakened is to repent from our sins. But what is the sin of Israel? Well, the scripture, when you read Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 15 to 17, you will realize that the main sin of the Negro Israel is that we abandoned our God to go and serve or follow and serve the gods of other nations. Yes, we left our own God to follow things that are not really God. That is why God is angry with us. That's why he put us under the 2-day punishment, which is a 2,000 years punishment. So now that you are awakened, recognize our sin, recognize our error. We left our God to go and serve, follow and serve gods of other nations. It became too bad that God said, okay, you go and serve your first gods, but after you have to return back here and serve me. So recognize our sin is we left our God to go and serve the gods of other nations. So that is why we are in this predicament that we are in today. This was foretold from the very beginning by our God that it will happen to us when we leave him to go and serve other gods. So the first thing that you that is now awakened need to do is to recognize our sins as a people of Israel. We left our God and we went to serve other gods of the nations. So if that is the case, to show true repentance on our part, we have to leave the gods of the nations and turn back and seek for our own God. We have to turn back and call on our own God if we need to receive mercy and if we need to obtain forgiveness. And the scripture brings this out also in Revelation chapter 18, verse 4 and 5. God's warning to all of us, his people, is that we should do what? Flee from Babylon the Great, which is the false religions of the nations. We should come, he said, come out of her, my people. We have gone to serve the religion and false gods of other nations. But to show true repentance, we have to come out from among them and seek for the gods of Israel, for Yahuwah, the God of Israel. Hosea chapter 6, verse 1 tells us, he said, return to our Yahuwah, our God, because he has torn us to pieces. But he is the one to heal, that will heal us after 3 days. So action is needed on our part as the awakened one of Israel. We need to return to calling on the name of our God, Yahuwah, and not the gods of other nations. We need to start seeking for our own God. And how do we see for our own God? On the pages of what is written. For these scriptures that are written for the people of Israel. So we need to return to seeking and searching for our God through the pages of what is written. And our God will give us understanding when we seek for him through the pages. So what else do we need to do? Or now that we are awakened, what should we do? Or what is required of us? Acts chapter 2, verse 38. Peter reminded or informed the people that listened to the message that he preached before the destruction of the nation of Israel. He said, you will receive the Holy Spirit. Yes, now that you are awakened, seek for the gift of the Holy Spirit of Yahuwah, the God of Israel. You are not seeking the spirit of the world or the spirit that is in the nations, for that is a false spirit. You are seeking for the Holy Spirit from Yahuwah, the God of Israel. And what will that spirit do for you? Like Jesus said, seek to be baptized by the Holy Spirit. It's more important than water baptism. So you have to seek to be baptized by the Holy Spirit. What the Spirit, Holy Spirit, will do for you is to, it will help you to gain the knowledge of what is written, the things that our God foretold long ago. The Holy Spirit will bring these things to your mind. He will give you understanding of them so that you can know what your Heavenly Father is doing for you. So, according to John chapter 14, verse 16 and 17, that spirit, like Peter said, is for the Israelites. You, the Negro Israel, that Holy Spirit is for you and not for any other nation. When that spirit is awakening in you, it will teach you the things foretold by your father long ago. It will help you to understand the things your father is doing so that you can truly walk with your God. The Holy Spirit will bring to our mind all the things that our God has told us of long ago. That Spirit will teach you, because the ones that will survive at the end, according to Isaiah 54, verse 13, will be the people that are taught by Yahuwah, the God of Israel himself. So seek for the Holy Spirit through prayer, through intercession, and through pleadings to Yahuwah, the God of Israel. Don't keep in mind, according to what Peter told the people in his time, Acts chapter 2, verse 21, everyone that call on the name of Yahuwah will be saved. So start, leave the gods of the nation alone and start calling on Yahuwah, the God of Israel, for your salvation. The next thing that is required of you now that you are awakened is to endure the punishment that is imposed on us until it ends. So this punishment upon the Negro Israel has an appointed time for it to end. So you have to endure, fortify yourself, bear the punishment and the discipline that is placed upon you. Accept correction from Yahuwah. The Bible says that God corrects everyone that he adopts as children. And that is what God is doing with us, using these 2,000 years of punishment in order to correct us and discipline us. Malachi chapter 3 verse 2. He says that God will do a refining of the Levites, of the people of Israel. God is going to refine us through this punishment. But who will endure until the day of his coming? So you have to endure. We are almost there. Just a few more years to endure until the end of this punishment. So you have awakened by the Spirit of your God, Yahuwah. Allow that Spirit to teach you. Allow that Spirit to guide you. Leave the gods of the nations, for the time that has passed is enough for us to serve their gods. Now it's time for us to return to serve Yahuwah, the God of Israel. So if you have liked this message or this video, click the like button, subscribe so you can be updated when I upload the next video. And until I see you next time, remain strong in your being awakened, but seek for Yahuwah, the God of Israel. Seek to be baptized by the Holy Spirit of our God and call upon his name for your salvation. More importantly, don't forget, our sin is that we left our God to serve the gods of other nations. So a true repentance will move us to leave the gods of the nations and return to searching and seeking for the God, Yahuwah, the God of Israel. So remain blessed until next time.